Last August, we began this Vox Populi tradition on Strictly Politics. At the end of every month, we hold a town hall discussion on the burning issue of the day. We believe that the voice of the people must be heard, and to be heard, they must be put on air. So it is Vox Populi night tonight on Strictly Politics, and we talk about crime, the spate of killings, carjackings, and just this afternoon, a bus bombing. With a little twist, we've invited two spokesmen from the Philippine National Police to join us in this open and honest discussion. Join us as we go behind the scenes to the battlefields of crime and politics. I'm your host, Beyond Tiveros. This is Strictly Politics. Tonight we're joined by former Makati Congressman Teddy Boy Locsin Jr. Hi, sir. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Leah Navarro, the executive director, Tama, of the Black and White Movement. Hi, Leah.
Hi.
Bobby Mendiola. He is a concerned parent and a regular panelist at the Ateneo School of Management. Hello, sir. Thank you for being here. Jaime Garchitorena is going to be joining us in a while. Blogger Noemi Dado, mom blogger on Twitter. Attorney Anel Diaz. Hi, Anel. Welcome back to the show. Jean Gregorio. Nung panahon ng elections, you were better known as the spokesman of Smartmatic.
Yes, but now I'm into organic farming.
Organic farming, yeah, you tweet a lot about that. And also joining us from the Philippine National Police, as I had said, is not Chief Superintendent Agrimero Cruz, but Senior Superintendent Edwin Butakan. He's spokesperson of the PNP Highway Patrol Group, given all the carjackings. Thank you, sir, for being here, and thank you for being so brave as to, as to come here tonight. Don't worry, they'll be very kind to you. And join us in a little while is a representative of General Agrimero Cruz, of the who is spokesman of the PNP. So let's begin. Sir, I'll begin with you na lang. Although I wanted to ask sana first yung representative ni General Cruz. Pero kayo na po muna. Yes. And I'm sure this is a question that's on most everyone's minds, no? You have all those carjackings, you have those killings, burnings, etc. And then this afternoon, bus bombing. What's happening?
Well, I would like to believe that these are isolated cases. As far as I'm concerned, I am actually with the Highway Patrol Group, and the latest of which the bombing incident is now being taken care of by investigators from the NCRPO, which is the territorial police, and we are giving support to them, considering that we are a national support unit. And as far as the Highway Patrol Group is concerned, again, and regarding the carjackings that is happening, the latest of which is the case of the two car dealers. We have been giving a lot of informations and intelligence materials for the fast resolution of the investigation of the killing of the car dealers.
Mm-hmm. Para kasing, Sir Colonel, parang may observation na there's a little bit too much of impunity. Para bang in broad daylight, or not necessarily in broad daylight, no? Pero parang ang lakas ng loob ng mga criminal gangs.
If we look into the trend, yung how they do this, the criminals, they do not think of the time or the place. They just commit this, and they commit these crimes whenever they have the opportunity to do it.
Mm-hmm. For the rest of the guests tonight on this Vox Populi episode, I'm sure you've thought the same things, no? But on what's happening, what's going on?
I was just wondering, and would like to ask the Colonel, is it because nawawalan, I think I'll just jump into it, and I hope you don't mind, nawawalan sila ng faith or trust sa ating kapulisan dahil we can blame it on media now or on the way media has progressed to new media, bad news flies really fast, and the police have been so criticized that sometimes people are already thinking na if they're that inept, no, then we can do anything. Mm-hmm. And it's unfortunate because I really want to have faith in the people who are supposed to protect me and all the rest of us. And I'm just hoping that apart from trying to assure us that you have everything under control, I'd like to know what it is that you're doing.
Well, actually, ma'am, thank you very much, ma'am. Actually, we cannot blame the media for this. And in the Philippine National Police, like our unit, we are also having some building our image. Like, actually, we have launched some quality service lane. Like,
magandang website ni.
Yes, we have.
Also in Twitter.
Actually, they're on Twitter, but they hardly tweet.
Yes, but you know, there are almost 140,000 policemen, and when one policeman is involved in a crime, then that's where everything falls down.
I guess nade-depress po kayo. Or nawawala ng
at one point, yes, because we also have our family and we have children going to school, and actually they see us on TV, and we are working hard for our family actually, and nandun yung mga criticisms na parang lahat ng police ganon.
Noemi,
ang perception kasi what I'm getting right now is ang perception nila weak ang sistema, the PNP. That's why madaling ito mag-commit. There is such a thing na if they
and
are not deterred. Yes,
the impunity is there because the
crime, you know, they say crime.
Yes.
What do they say? Crime does not pay. So I'm just wondering, is there something that has been not resolved before? That's why they're so brazen, and you know.
Actually, like this, the case of this, the killing of the car dealers. If you look into the profile of the suspects, especially the brothers, there's about 40 cases that they have committed, that they've been charged with, from simple theft. It started from 2007 up to this year. They have they started from a simple theft, robbery, estafa. Then they went into carnapping with homicide. Now, we have made some research, and we looked into the status of those cases which have been filed against them, and there are cases like the carnapping with homicide and rape cases, and the courts have recommended like for further investigation, for further verification. I don't know about that. I'm not a legal expert, but...
Maybe it would help if you tell us what cases were solved, what you did, so this will, you know, be more publicized than what the crimes are, because what we know is nothing is being resolved. So I'd like you to, especially you're active in Twitter, to, you know, tell us the good news, something like that, so
well,
we can spread it.
That is a good suggestion.
Because like Anina, people are asking what's happening to you. There's nobody replying in Twitter.
Yeah, what's happening? Yes. Well, that's a question we should also ask. Like I said, a representative of General Cruz is here, so senior superintendent.
Yes, ma'am.
Noel Baraceros, deputy spokesperson.
Yes.
Sir, so can you give us an answer there? What's happening? Parang ang lakas ng loob ng mga criminal gangs, are malakas bang loob nila because they perceive that the Philippine National Police is weak, or what?
Actually, we should look at it this way. For a crime to be committed, there are three elements. First is the means, and then the opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
And then yung motive.
Mm-hmm.
Yung motive, we cannot do much about that. Pero we can control, for example, the means and the opportunities to reduce, for example, yung opportunity na makapag-commit sila ng crime.
Yeah.
That's why we are also looking, for example, yung means, yung paggamit nila ng baril. That's why we are requesting now, for example, the stiffer penalties now for the imposition of illegal possession of firearms, for example. So ito yung mga tinitingnan natin, yung mga batas din natin. Take, for example, yung case nila
Dominguez.
Nakakapag-bail sila because of weak yung kan natin.
So these are the things. Sir,
any of these suspects members of gun clubs? Because, you know, they've been glorifying gun clubs ever since the election of the president. Yeah, as if it required any brains to fire a gun.
Yes, sir.
In fact, I took up shooting, and you know, during that time, some experts from Arizona, and they said actually to be a good shooter, you need to have a black brain. Do you think that the glorification of these gun clubs, are they members of gun clubs?
The Dominguez brothers, sir, are they members of gun clubs?
We have no specific information on that.
Do they have licensed firearms?
Actually, yeah. I want to attack the police for something that happened a long time ago. Yeah. But I think the reason why, you know, there has been carnapping, really. I mean, I hear this from my friends for years.
Yeah.
All these crimes have been happening. Now they're getting bolder. I don't see it because the police are considered weak.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's because they're catching on to them. Mm-hmm. And these guys are getting desperate. A successful criminal does not burn people, does not do these things in a public way, does not invite media attention. They just keep carnapping quietly, as they've been doing. I was afraid of the epidemic of crime. I'm sorry, President Ramos. When Ramos became president, he was chief PC, right?
Yes.
The signal seemed to have gone out to all uniformed men, good and bad, but mostly bad. Uy, one of us is now president.
Mm-hmm.
Time to steal.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why you had an epidemic of bank robberies that was so brutal and so systematic. We had to, I was in UCPB, we had to tell the guards, pagpasok ang tao sa banko, may barid, bigyan mo kaagad ang pera. Don't put up a fight. I don't see that now. I think that the boldness of the criminals is a sign of desperation. I'm not trying to excuse you guys, but I think they're onto them. The fact that you guys have the lowdown on these guys, you're just moving in on them, and the courts just keep letting them go. But I think you have a grip on these guys. I think this is a sign of desperation. So, about why I'm angry, I'll tell you when the police are bad.
Mm-hmm.
When my reporter, Jose Lu Villanueva, was robbed in a bus of his cell phone, and he didn't want to give it because it wasn't his. And the one who took it, had yung pampatay ng baboy, it's a sharp object, and he said, ayaw mo bigyan sa akin, ha? So they went to him, and then they put the spike here, and they just put him and killed him, okay? I called up the Pasig chief of police and I said, it's terrible. I mean, and you know what? The police caught the guy.
Mm-hmm.
Five policemen caught him. The five policemen were immediately demoted for catching him because he was the son of a drug lord. Well, actually, the drug lord was a lady. So they were immediately demoted. And then the chief police called me and said, sir, meron naman ako ditong 11-year-old there. Pwede na yun.